beautiful woman that there ever was. Let's go tell Uncle Henry and Auntie Anne. They'll take care of her. Aunt Em? Aunt Em?
Oh,
Em. No, Miss Gulch, did you tell me?
Please, we're coming.
Oh, but Aunt Em, she hit him.
She hit him? Oh, this old incubator's gone bad, and we're about to lose a lot of our chicks.
The poor little things. Oh, but Aunt Em, Miss Gulch, he told her right over the back with a rake, just because she says he gets in her garden.
Dorothy, please.
Oh, but he doesn't do it every day. He just once or twice a week.
Busy.
Well, Henry, can't you do something?
I am doing something, honey. So just keep out of our hair.
All right.
Who is the genius who suggested we move the wagon before the wheel was on?
Well, it ain't so heavy with one less. That makes sense, don't it?
Sense or no sense, when I lift this axle up, you two shove her on.
Zeke, Hickory, no, Miss Gulch, did it, Toto?
I swear, that made this new wheel smaller than the other three.
She tried to kill him.
Bigger or smaller, get that on there before my arms are pulled clear out of the sides. I ain't a statue, you know. I ain't made of iron.
Okay, okay.
Why won't anyone listen? Don't you care about Toto?
Get down my finger!
What am I going to do about Miss Gulch? Just because Toto chases her old cat.
Now look at Dorothy. You ain't using your head about Miss Gulch. Ain't you got no brains?
Sure I have brains.
Then why don't you use them? When you come home, don't go by Miss Gulch's place. Then Toto won't get in her garden, and you won't get in no trouble, see?
Quit standing there. Get that junk out of the wagon. We got a parcel of lumber to haul before the weather turns.
Right away, Miss Gale.
Zeke, what am I going to do?
Well, for a start, kid, don't let that old Gulch have to try and buffalo you. She ain't nothing to be afraid of. You gotta stand up to her, that's all. With a little courage, a little grit.
I'm not afraid of her.
That's what I wanted to hear. Walk with your head up, your chest out, and the next time she squawks, you just stroll right up to her and spit in her eye. That's what I do.
Would you really?
Well, sure I would. In this life, you gotta walk tall and shoot straight. Then you got no reason to be scared of nothing or nobody.
Oh, Zeke, are you all right?
What are you trying to do, kill a guy?
Well, how can you be so cruel?
Oh, it was just a rib, Dorothy.
Can't you see how scared he is?
Who was scared?
You were scared. If you were a jackrabbit, you'd be the next county by now.
Here, here, what's all this jabber-rabbit going on when there's work to be done? I know three shifts of farm hands that'll be out of a job before they know it.
Oh, we was just having a little fun, Mrs. Gale.
A farm is no place for fun. If you want fun, go join the circus.
I might just do that. Be a strong man. See the world.
Well, don't start posing for it now. Here, here, can't work on an empty stomach. Have some cookies.
Gosh, Miss Gale.
They're fresh baked.
Oh, thanks.
Mm-hmm. Well,
you don't have to sit down to eat them. See, go feed them hogs before they worry themselves into anemia.
Yes, ma'am.
And you too. Get that wagon hitched up.
Honey, I'm really. This cold such.
Dorothy, stop imagining things. You always get yourself into a fret over nothing.
Well,
now, you do us all a favor today. Go find yourself a place where you won't get into any trouble.
Some place where there isn't any trouble. I wonder if there is such a place, Toto. There must be. A place you can get to by a boat or a train. It's far, far away. Behind the moon. Beyond the rain.
Clouds talking up the sky.
I've never skulked in my life, Miss Gulch, and I ain't about to start now.
I need to speak with you and your wife right away about Dorothy.
Dorothy? Why? What's Dorothy done?
What's she done? Why, I am all but lame from the bite on my leg.
You mean she bit you?
No, her dog.
Oh, she bit her dog, eh?
Afternoon, Miss Gulch. Just made a fresh batch of cookies, if you care to sit a while.
I'm afraid I have no appetite, Miss Gale. Indeed, I'm so shaken by the ferocious attack of your niece's vicious dog, I may never eat again.
If you don't eat, you'll waste away, and I'd hate to see you dwindle.
Dorothy, could you go get Toto a minute? I am sure if Dorothy's offended you in any way, she'll be only too happy to apologize as best she can.
It's gone beyond apologies, Miss Gale. I've laid an official complaint with the county sheriff.
Was he sober?
Dorothy, Miss Gulch here seems very upset.
That dog is a menace to the community.
That's not true.
As an act of public service, young woman, I'm taking that dog to the sheriff and make sure he's destroyed.
Destroyed? Toto? Oh, you can't. You mustn't. Oh, Uncle Henry, Auntie Anne, you won't let her, will you?
Of course we won't. Will we, Anne?
Oh, Auntie Anne, Toto didn't mean to. He didn't know he was doing anything wrong. I'm the one ought to be punished. You can set him to bed without supper.
Oh, you hear how sorry the child is. Perhaps if she promises to give your place a wide berth.
If you don't hand that dog over now, I'll bring a damage suit that'll take your whole farm. There's a law protecting folks against dogs that bite.
Well, what if she keeps him tied up? He's quite gentle, with gentle folk, that is.
Well, that's for the sheriff to decide. Here's the order allowing me to take him, unless you want to go against the law.
Uh-huh.
What's it say, Henry?
Just what she says. You gotta hand him over, Dorothy.
No! I won't let you take him!
Dorothy, we can't go against the law. I'm afraid poor Toto will have to go.
Now you're seeing reason.
No!
This is what I'm taking him in, so he can't attack me again.
Oh, no, I won't let you take him! Oh, you go away! I'll bite you myself!
Dorothy!
You wicked old witch! Uncle Henry, Auntie Anne, you won't let her take him, will you?
Oh. Stop her!
No use running, Dorothy.
Hickory, I thought you were my friend.
Oh, he is your friend. We all are.
He can't fight the law, honey. Some things are bigger than all of us.
Let me have him, Dorothy.
Oh, please. Please.
Put him in the basket, Henry.
Now you're seeing reason.
Don't, Uncle Henry. Oh, Toto.
Elmira Gulch. Just because you own half the county does not give you the right to tell the rest of us what to do. For 23 years, I have been dying to tell you exactly what I thought of you, and now, well, being a Christian woman, I can't say it.
Well, I can, and if you don't want to hear it, you better pedal your carcass on out of here.
Don't take kindly to that kind of talk, Henry Gale. Just remember, I have friends in high places.
Then go climb on your broomstick and go visit them. Got those horses hitched to the wagon yet?
Nearly done, Mr. Gale.
Nearly ain't good enough. You get it done right now, because the skies are turning darker every minute.
Come inside, honey.
No, I'm not going anywhere with you.
What did you expect me to do? She had an order from the sheriff. Wave a magic wand and make it disappear?
You still could have tried, at least. You stood there like you were stuck or something.
I just couldn't think of anything. I'm sorry.
One mean old woman, and you were scared of her.
It weren't my place to interfere.
And you're worst of all. You stopped Toto getting away. I just hate you.
Oh, don't say that, Dorothy. You make me feel terrible inside. Like my heart was all torn up.
I don't care. I never want to see any of you ever again. Ever, ever, ever. Toto was the only friend I had in the world. I got no one to talk to, no one to play with. I'll never see him again as long as I live. Oh, Toto! Oh, Toto, darling, you got away from that horrible woman, you wonderful dog. Oh, but she'll be coming back for you any minute. Oh, we've got to get away. We've got to run away. Oh, we need food for me and a bone for you, and then we're going away and we're never, ever coming back.
Here, doggy.
He can't have enjoyed your company much.
Where the little girl is, that's where I'll find the dog. Kindly bring her out here.
You never give up, do you? Dorothy? Dorothy?
She ain't in the house, Henry. And that plate of cookies is missing. And my picture on the mantel, that's gone too.
Sounds like you've a runaway on your hands. If she's on the road, I'll find her. And I'll take that dog back for good.
If you're so anxious to have that dog, you should have looked after it better.
Don't blame me. The basket is faulty. The last time I buy anything from a charity bazaar.
If it were done, it were best that it be done equally on both sides. Well, 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 why are we here? House guests, eh? Now then, who might you be? No, you're traveling in disguise. No, sorry. You're going on a visit. No, I'm wrong. You're running away.
How did you guess?
Professor Marvel never guesses. He knows! Now then, why are you running away?
Well,
no, don't tell me. They don't understand you at home. They don't appreciate you. You want to see other lands, big cities, big mountains, big oceans.
It's like you can read what's inside me.
It is my trade. My calling. See what it says on the side of my conveyance. But where are my manners? Please, have a seat. Come on, let's get better acquainted. Now then, where were we?
Oh, please, Professor, why can't we go with you and see all the crowned heads of Europe?
Do you know any? Oh, you mean the thing? Well, I never do anything without first consulting my crystal. So stay right there. That's right, make yourself comfortable. Whilst I pull out of the air. Out of the thin air, this very genuine, magic, authentic crystal used by the priests of Isis and Osiris in the days of the pharaohs of Egypt, in which Cleopatra first observed the approach of Julius Caesar and Mark Antony, and so on. So now then, hold out your hands and help me reach out into. Now, close your eyes for a moment, my dear, to help us to be better in tune with the infinite. We cannot do these things without first reaching out into the infinite. Yes. All right. Okay, open your eyes. Now, we'll gaze into the crystal. What's this I see? A house with a picket fence.
That's our farm.
Yes, and there's a woman. She's wearing a polka dot dress. Her face is careworn.
That's Aunt Em.
Yes, her name is Emily.
That's right.
Yes.
What's she doing?
Well, I can't quite say it. Why, she's crying. Someone has hurt her. Someone has nearly broken her heart.
Who would do that?
Well, I don't know. It's someone she loves very much. Someone she's cared for and taken care of in sickness.
I had the measles once, and she stood by me every minute.
Uh-huh.
But that was when I was very young. She doesn't care about me at all anymore, and I don't care about her.
Well, that's not what the crystal says.
They were going to kill Toto, and she did nothing to stop them.
Well, I don't see any of that in the crystal. What I do see is a woman who cares for you very much, does the best she can, and misses you something terrible.
What's she doing now?
Yes, well, what's this I see? She's putting her hand on her heart. She's dropping down onto the bed.
Oh, you don't suppose she could be really sick, do you? Oh, I've got to get home right away.
Well, what's this? I thought you were coming with me.
Oh, no, I've got to get home. Thank you for your help, Professor Marvel.
Goodbye, safe journey. I better get the horse under cover. There's a storm blowing in. A whopper! Poor little kid. I hope she gets home all right.
I know we're not in Kansas. Are you a good witch or a bad witch? Who, me? I'm not a witch at all. I'm Dorothy Gale from Kansas.
Oh. Well, is that the witch?
Toto? Toto's my dog.
Oh, a little muddy. It appears that a new witch has just robbed a house on the wicket to the east. And there's the house, and here you are. And those legs are all that's left of the wicket to the east. And so, what the mudflakes want to know is, are you a good witch or a bad witch?
But I've already told you, I'm not a witch at all. Witches are old and ugly. What was that?
The mudflakes. They're laughing because I'm a witch. And Glinda is a witch.
Oh, I beg your pardon, but I've never heard of a beautiful witch before.
Only bad witches are ugly. Muffins are happy because you have freed them from the wicked of the east.
But if you please, what are munchkins?
The little people who live in this land. This is Mudkin Land. It's all right. You may all come out and thank her. Come out, come out, wherever you are, and meet the young lady who fell from the star. She fell from the sky, she fell very far, and Kansas, she says, is the name of the star.
Kansas, she says, is the name of the star.
She brings you good news, or haven't you heard? And she fell out of Kansas, a miracle occurred.
It really was no miracle. What happened was just this. The wind began to switch, the house to pitch, and suddenly the hinges started to unhitch. Just then, the witch, to satisfy an itch, flying on her broomstick, dumping for a hitch.
Sing it high, sing it high.
told her she wouldn't want me for battle.
You stay out of this, Glinda, or I'll fix you as well.
I'll fill the battle. You have no power while I'm here. Be gone before somebody drops a house on you.
Very well. I abide my time. And as for you, my fine lady, it's true I can't attend to you here and now as I like. But after a suitable period of mourning, I'll have those slippers and my revenge, too. So best try to stay out of my way. Just try. I'll get you eventually, my pretty. And your little dog, too.
Is a very nice way.
Who said that? Oh, don't be silly, Toto. Scarecrows don't talk.
It's pleasant down that way, too.
That's funny. Wasn't he pointing the other way?
Of course. People do go both ways.
Why, you did say something, didn't you? Are you doing that on purpose, or can't you make up your mind?
I haven't got a brain, only strong. So I haven't got a mind to make up.
How can you talk if you haven't got a brain?
Well, I don't know. But some people without brains do an awful lot of talking, don't they?
I guess you're right.
Can you get down?
Oh, down? Oh no. You see, I got this pole stuck up my back.
Is there any way I can help you?
Well, I'm not too bright about doing things, but if you just bend the nail down and back, maybe I'll just slip on.
We'll certainly try. My, it's an awful stiff nail.
Oh, there goes some more of me again.
Does it hurt you?
Oh, no, I just keep picking it up and putting it back in again.
Let me help you.
Oh, my, it's good to be free. Did I scare you?
No, I just thought you hurt yourself.
And I didn't scare you?
Of course not.
I didn't think so. See? I can't even scare a crow.
Howdy, neighbor.
They come from miles around just to eat from my field.
Howdy, scarecrow.
Laugh in my face. You see? I'm not afraid of a witch. I'm not afraid of anything. Except for maybe a lighted match.
Oh, I don't blame you for that.
Oh, but I'd face a whole box full of them for the chance of getting me some brains. Look, I won't be in any trouble because I don't need a thing. And I won't try to manage things because I can't think. Oh, won't you take me with you?
Of course I will.
Hey! I'm going to get me a brain. Let's go!
You have to remember Tomo. To us!
There was a wizard of Oz. It never was, there was. It was because.
alive?
Oh, no, Scarecrow. You're the liveliest friend I ever had.
Well, why, thank you. Just for that, you can have as much of my hay as you'd like, and then you won't be hungry anymore.
It's a very kind offer, but I don't need hay.
Well, you don't have to worry about me. So long as I keep my legs well stuffed, I can walk to Emerald City no matter what shape I'm in up top.
It's a very kind offer, but... Oh, look, Scarecrow! Apples!
Apples? What's apples?
In the trees.
Oh, you mean those little red birds hanging upside down by one leg?
Oh, they're not birds. They're something you eat. They're delicious.
Ouch! Just what do you think you're doing?
Oh, we've been walking for a long ways and I was hungry and... Did she just say something?
She was hungry.
She was hungry.
How would you like it if someone came along to pick something off of you?
I'm sorry. I keep forgetting I'm not in Kansas.
Come along, Dorothy. You don't want any of those apples. Yuck.
Are you hinting my apples aren't what they ought to be?
Oh, no. It's just that she doesn't like little green worms.
Worms? Did he say we had worms?
That's what it sounded like to me.
I'll show you how to get apples. Yeah, worms. Worms, caterpillars, and probably a whole bunch of little woodlice, too.
How dare you? Let's give it to him, girls.
Take that.
We like them just fine. Munchkin maiden, whose mother hated me. So, to keep me from marrying her daughter, she hired the Wicked Witch of the West, who put an evil spell on my axe. When I tried to chop down a tree, well, I chopped off my leg instead.
Why?
You chopped your leg off?
But, by good fortune, I knew of a wonderful tinsmith who made me a new leg, almost as good as the old one. So, I went back to work, and you know what happened?
Oh, something terrible, I bet.
I chopped off my other leg.
Why?
Oh, you should have got a new axe.
Well, that may be so, but I got me a new leg instead. And I went back to work. I sure were persistent. Oh, I sometimes wish I hadn't got these new pair of arms, though. Because the last time I swung my axe was the worst time of all.
Well, I don't want to hear this.
What happened?
I chopped myself right down the middle.
Oh, you poor thing.
So, the tinsmith gave me a new head and a new bottle. But on the way home, I got caught in a terrible rainstorm, and I rusted solid.
Just wasn't your day, was it?
I've been here ever since.
You're perfect now.
My neck! Hey, perfect. Bang on my chest if you think I'm perfect. Go ahead. Bang on it.
Oh, beautiful. What an echo.
It's empty. The tinsmith forgot to give me a heart.
No heart?
No heart. As long as I have no heart, I can never love my munchkin maid.
Oh, don't cry, Tin Man. You'll rest solid.
I used to carve her name in every tree.
You can say that again.
Said a tin man, rattling his chin, to the straw that sat on the eye.
Oh, Smith, give me tin man.
When a man's an empty kettle, he should be on his mettle, but yet I'm torn apart. Just perhaps I'm presuming that I could be kind of human if I only had a heart. I'd be tender, I'd be gentle, and often sentimental regarding love and art. I'd be friends with the sparrows and that boy who shoots the arrows if I only had a heart. Picture me, a balcony, a poem, a voice. Your emotion, jealousy, devotion, and really feel the part. I could stay young and chipper and that locket with the zipper if I only had a
we'll be right back.
right, but I think it'll get darker before it gets lighter.
You don't suppose we'll meet wild animals, do you?
We might.
Oh.
Animals that eat straw?
Some, but mostly lions and tigers and bears.
Lions?
And tigers?
And bears.
Oh. Lions and tigers and bears? Oh my. Lions and tigers and bears? Oh my. Lions and tigers and bears? Oh my. Lions and tigers and bears? Oh my.
Lions and tigers and bears? Oh my. Lions and tigers and bears? Oh my. Lions and tigers and bears? Oh my.
I'll fight you both together if you want. I'll fight you with one paw behind my back. I'll fight you standing on one foot. I'll fight you with my eyes closed. Oh, pull an axe on me, eh? Stick up with me, eh?
Go away and leave us alone.
Oh, scared, huh? Afraid, huh? How long could you stay fresh in a can? Come and fight your shivering junkyard. Put your hands up on one side of the bagel, have you?
See, you're getting personal now, Lion.
Yeah, teach him a lesson.
What's the matter? Who are you teaching him?
Well, I hardly know him.
Why, I'll get you anyway, little pee-wee.
What
did you do that for? I didn't bite him.
But you tried to. It's bad enough picking on a straw man. But when you go around picking on poor little dogs...
Well, you didn't have to go and hit me, did ya? Is my nose bleeding?
Of course not. My, what a fuss you're making. Naturally, when you go around picking on things weaker than you are, why, you're nothing but a big coward.
You're right. I am a coward. I haven't got any courage at all. I even scare myself. Look at the cycles around my eyes. I haven't slept in weeks.
Oh, have you tried counting sheep?
That doesn't do any good. I'm afraid of them.
That's too bad. But why don't you come along with us? We're on our way to see the wizard now to get him a heart.
And him a brain.
I'm sure he could give you some courage.
Well, you wouldn't feel degraded to be seen in the company of a cowardly lion. I would.
Of course not.
Oh, gee. That's awful nice of you. You see, my life has been simply unbearable. My own family's disowned me. When I was just a small cub, my father took me to the top of a high mountain and waved his paw around and said, "One day, son, all this will be yours." I was terrified.
Why's that?
I was scared.
Oh,
fine.
It's all right. The wizard will fix everything.
Well, at least he'd be safe if I come with you.
How come?
No self-respecting wild animal will come anywhere near me. Said a lion, a poor neurotic lion, to a miss who listened to him rip. Oh, the Lord made me a lion, but the Lord forgot to make me brave. Life is sad, believe me, missing. Were you born to be a sissy without a feminine voice? But I could change my habits, never more be scared of rabbits if I only had the nerve. I'm afraid there's no denying, I'm just a dandelion, afraid I don't deserve. But I could show my prowess. Be a lion, not a mouse, if I only had the nerve.
Oh, you be in your stride, a king down to the core.
You could bore the thing you've never bored before.
And then I'd roar, and roar some more. I would show the dinosaurs, who's king around the force, a king they better slay. Why, with my regal beezer, I could be another Caesar if I only had the knife. I'd be brave as a blizzard.
I'd be gentle as a lizard.
As a gizzard.
If the wizard is a wizard.
the knife.
Thank you. waiting for?
To us!
Thank you.
blah 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 blah. Ready to sing on the rock. That's how we keep you in good health, and you don't like that us.
I'll be home in time for supper.
In another hour, I'll be king of the forest. Long live the king. If I were king of the forest, not queen, not duke, not prince, my ring or rose, but the forest will be certain, not cut, not chilled. The man is saved me a fish or fowl. Thank you.
Imposters!
What about a hippopotamus?
A thrashing from top to bottom.
Suppose they met an elephant?
A ramp-up in something.
What if it were a brontosaurus?
Well, I'll show him who's king of a forest.
How?
How? Courage. What makes a king of a slave pup have courage? What makes the elephant large as a tusk? And the meanness called a dusty actus. What makes the muscle guard his what makes the snake the seventh wonder? What makes the dog come up like thunder? What makes the hot tub so hot? What makes the apron cut? What do I got?
Great and powerful. Who are you? Who are you? Who are you? Who are you?
If you please, I'm Dorothy, the suave and meek. We've come to ask you if we
can. Silence!
Oh,
the great and powerful Oz knows why you have come. Step forward, Tin Man. You dare to come to me to ask for a heart, do you? You clinking, clanking, clattering collection of polygynous junk!
Yes, Your Honor. You see, a while back, we were walking down the yellow brick road and—
Quiet!
Oh.
And you, Scarecrow, have the effrontery to ask me for a brain. You billowing bale of bovine fodder.
Yes, Your Majesty. Your Excellency. Your Wizardry.
Enough! And you, liar. Well? beneficent Oz has every intention of granting your request.
What's that? What'd he say?
Are you all right?
I'm just a little deaf, Mama. What'd he say?
He said he's going to help us after all.
Yes.
But first, you must prove yourselves worthy by performing a very small task.
Oh. A small task? Is that all?
Name it, and it's half done.
Bring me the broomstick of the Wicked Witch of the West.
But if we do that, we'll have to kill her to get it.
Bring me her broomstick, and I shall grant your requests. Now go.
But what if she kills us first?
I said go!
Nico, where
Welcome to the Haunted Forest?
No, no. The one that said, if you got this far, you're lost.
Oh, here's another notice.
Oh, I hope this one's a little more reassuring.
I'd turn back if I were you.
Oh, my God.
I believe there's spooks around here.
Oh, that's silly. Spooks? That's ridiculous.
You don't believe in spooks?
No. Why only fools believe in... Are you all right?
Oh, I do believe in spooks.
So do I. What's happening?
Oh, under the sight of the bites.
They're not birds. They're monkeys.
Flying monkeys!
Fine job we did protecting Dorothy.
Help!
Oh, what happened to you?
They ripped my legs off, and they threw them over there. And they ripped my arm off, and they threw it over there.
Why, Scarecrow, that's you all over.
Well, I would, but I can't reach my legs.
Here you go. And then we'll go find Dorothy.
And the lion will lead us.
Yeah,
you.
That's right.
Wicked witch, or no wicked witch, gods or no gods, I'll tear them apart. I may not come out alive, and I'll go down flame. There's only one thing I want you fellows to do.
What's that?
Suck me up.
Away from you. He got away.
Look out! Look out!
Oh, who's there? Who's there?
Yo-wee-o! Yo! Yo-wee-o! Yo! Yo-wee-o! Yo! Yo-wee-o! Yo!
Lion! Girl! Tin Man!
but I have to get back to Kansas. Oh, the witch's broomstick. May we have it?
Please, take it with you.
Oh, thank you. Now we can go back to the wizard and tell him the wicked witch is dead.
Oh, the wicked witch is dead!
Will never be practical until they're made unbreakable.
Oh, but I still want one.
Well, back where I come from, we have people who do nothing all day but good deeds. They're called good deed doers.
Oh.
And their hearts are no bigger than yours, but they have one thing you haven't got. A testimonial. Therefore, in consideration of your kindness,
I take great pleasure at this time in presenting you this small token of our esteem and affection. And remember, my sentimental friend, that a heart is not judged based on how much you love, but how much you are loved by others.
It ticks! Hope! Hope! Listen to my heart! It ticks!
Read what my medal says.
A warning for courage!
Ain't it the truth? Ain't it the truth?
They're all so wonderful.
But what about Dorothy?
Yes, well.
Yeah, what about Dorothy? What about her?
Yeah, Dorothy next.
Well, you forced me into a cataclysmic decision. In order to get Dorothy back to Kansas, it'll be necessary to take her there myself.
Really? Oh, but are you a wise enough wizard to manage it?
Child, you cut me to the quick. Why, I'm an old Kansas man myself. Premier balloon is par excellence for the Miracle Wonderland Carnival Company. Until one day, while performing spectacular feats of stratospheric skill never before experienced by civilized man, the balloon failed to return to the fair.
That's
it? Frightened, were you?
Frightened? Why, you are looking at the man who has laughed at death, sneered at doom, and chuckled at catastrophe. I was petrified. And then the winds changed, and the balloon floated down into the heart of this noble city, where I was instantly acclaimed as First Wizard Deluxe.
Deluxe? From the French, attaining to luxury.
Well, there were a few luxuries came for the job, but I took it anyway, pretending the balloon against the advent of a quick getaway. And the balloon is ready for flight, and in that conveyance, Dorothy, you and I shall return to the land of E Pluribus Unum. Step this way. Citizens of Oz, I, your wizard, Per Ardua Ad Alta, am about to embark upon a hazardous and technically unexplainable journey into the outer stratosphere. To confer, converse, and otherwise hobnob with my brother wizards. And I hereby decree that until that time, if any, that I shall return, the Scarecrow, by virtue of his superior brain, shall rule in my stead, assisted by the Tin Man, by virtue of his magnificent heart, and the Lion, by virtue of his courage. Obey them as you would me. Thank you, my friend. Thank you. And now I believe it is time to cast off. Climb aboard, Dorothy, climb aboard.
Climb aboard, Missy, while the wind is in your favor.
But where's Toto? I can't go without him.
Oh, don't worry, I'll get him for you.
Oh, don't let go of the rope. This is highly irregular procedure.
Oh, the balloon is going up.
Help, help.
Oh, no.
This is most unnatural.
You can't go without me.
It's too late.
You're done.
Oh, come back.
I gotta go back. I don't know how it works. Oh. Goodbye, everybody.
Bye.
The idiot guard ruined my exit.
We don't want you to go, Dorothy.
I have to go back to Kansas.
Don't you love us, Dorothy?
You know I do, but there's a place and people I love more. Now it's further away than the furthest dream. Oh, Scarecrow, I'll never go back to Kansas. Never, never, never.
Oh.
Never. It's a very, very long time, Dorothy.
You help me? Will you help me?
You don't need to be helped any longer. You've always had the power to go back to Kansas.
I have?
Well, why didn't you tell her sooner?
Because she wouldn't have believed me. She had to learn it for herself.
Oh. What did you learn, Dorothy?
Well, I guess I've learned that it isn't enough just to want to see Uncle Henry and Auntie Em, and that if I ever go looking for my heart's desire and I don't find it in my own backyard, then I never really lost it in the first place. Is that right?
That's all it is.
That's so easy. I should have thought of it for you.
And I should have felt it in my heart.
Me too, if I had the courage of my conviction.
No, she had to learn it for herself. Now those magic slippers will get you home in 2 seconds.
Toto too?
Toto too?
so hard to say goodbye. I love you all so much. Tin Man, oh, don't cry. You'll rust so dreadfully. Oh, goodbye.
Now I know I have a fault, because it's breaking.
Oh, Lion, I know it isn't right, but I'm going to miss the way you used to holler when you hadn't yet found your courage.
Where you go, I think I'll do a little more hollering.
Oh. Dear Scarecrow, you were my first friend here, and I think I'll miss you most of all.
Having a brain doesn't make parting any easier. Goodbye, Dorothy. I'll think about you always.
Are you ready now?
Yes, before I change my mind and stay forever.
Now close your eyes and click your heels together three times and repeat to yourself over and over. There is no place like home.
There's no place like home. There's no place like home.
So we won't have to listen to that old biddy tell her leg gets out of plaster.
Then Toto's safe. You hear that, Toto? You're safe.